In this exercise, we will examine the maintenance procedures for our Spitfire rotary shotgun nozzle. The Spitfire operates from 5,000 to 22,000 psi with flows from 2 to 15 gallons per minute. Here we have a close-up of the Spitfire. Note the shield protecting the nozzles. At the other end, the inlet nut is available in either half-inch MPT or 9/16 MP. Begin disassembly by securing the tool in a vise using the wrench flats on the inlet nut. Loosen the shield with a crescent wrench, unscrew the shield, and set it aside. Remove the O-ring at the top of the sleeve. Applying gentle downward pressure on the sleeve will help expose the O-ring. With the O-ring off, you can slide the sleeve up and off the tool. Now remove the second O-ring from the bottom. Loosen the body from the inlet nut using the wrench flats at the base of the body. Unscrew the body to expose the inlet nut. Now flip the tool in the vise using the wrench flats on the head to secure. With a 7/16 socket wrench, locate the nut on the inside of the body. Loosen the nut. Unscrew the shaft from the head. The shaft will drop out of the body, and now your disassembly is complete. Wash and blow dry all parts. Prepare for assembly. Begin by brushing blue goop on the threads of the head. Next, slide the shaft into the body and hand tighten the head to the shaft. Now move the assembly to the vise and secure using the wrench flats on the head. Tighten the shaft to the head using the 7/16 socket wrench. Now hand tighten the inlet nut into the shaft. With the inlet nut hand tight, flip the tool in the vise. Secure the tool in the vise using the wrench flats on the inlet nut. Now tighten the body to the inlet nut using the wrench flats as shown. Slide the first O-ring down the base of the body. Next, slide the sleeve over the body. Now mount the second O-ring at the top of the sleeve. Brush blue goop on the threads of the inlet nut and screw on the shield. Tighten with a crescent wrench. Your assembly is now complete. We recommend drying your Spitfire with compressed air after each use. Remove the nozzles when drying and blow the inlet shaft as well. Lubricate the tool with WD-40. We recommend storing your Spitfire in a dust-free case or plastic wrap in between uses. Thanks, and as always, our technical specialists are on hand to answer any questions or procedural issues you may have.